A lichen actually consists of two organisms, a fungus, an alga, or cyanobacteria. Or so we thought for 140 years. In lichen, the fungus provides a home, while the algae provides nutrients. Together they form the unusual structures that grow on the surfaces of rocks and trees. Lichens break down the rocks into soil, take up pollutants from the air, and live in places most other organisms avoid. It's hard to do genetics in lichen. They grow slowly, bind themselves tightly to their substrates, and when they are sequenced, they yield a mishmash of DNA from two organisms. Take these two related lichens. They're different colors, and one makes a toxin. Looking at both the fungus and the algae gene activity in the two lichens, researchers saw no differences. But when they looked at the activity of all the genes, they discovered a yeast was also part of these lichens. So the twosome was actually a threesome. These yeast genes were more active in one of the lichens, possibly explaining the difference in color. To prove the yeast were really there, the researchers labeled each of the lichen's organisms with fluorescent tags. They discovered that the yeast coat the outer wall of the fungal hairs and are surrounded by toxic acidic crystals. The algae line the inside of the wall. They found the yeast in many other lichen on different continents, suggesting that this is a widespread three-way partnership, gone undiscovered for over 140 years.